Hello, students. Today we're going to learn how to put in a basic problem with your TI calculator. So what you're going to do here is you're going to put these in exactly as you see them, and it will make it much easier for you. So what you're going to do is just put them straight in the calculator. So the first one, I have 9 to the third. So 9, and we went over how to put in exponents in the previous video, 9 caret 3. And if I'm up in the air still, you see I'm up here. If I'm up here, what's going to happen is anything else I type is going to be up there. So you don't want to do that. When you put in 9 caret 3, if it jumps up to the top, right? It jumps up to the top, you're just going to use your over arrow to come down. That's like coming down. Don't hit down, it's not going to go down, just hit the over arrow. So 9 to the third divided by, and when you hit the division bar, you're going to get a slash. When you hit division, you're going to get a slash, 81 minus 2. Please do not try and do it in parts and do the order of operation yourself. Just put it in straight as you see it, and you'll get the proper answer. So that's 7. We're going to do the same one for number 2. Now number 2, that's 50 minus, now you see the parentheses here. The calculator also has parentheses right here on top of the 8 and the 9. So you don't take the parentheses out. You still put in exactly what you see. So that's 50 minus parentheses, 41 minus 4, close your parentheses, hit enter, and you will get 13, which is the appropriate answer. The next one, the same thing. 24 divided by, it's going to give you the slash, 2 squared, and we talked about squared, you can either use the caret button or you can use the square button over here. I'm going to use the square button. And you see this time I'm not in the air, so it's right where I should be. So then I just need to add 5. And then my answer is 11. For the next one, I'm going to put it in again as I see it. But you might want to remember that the parentheses and the multiplication next to a number means the same thing. So this right here, you don't need both of them, but you can't get rid of the parentheses. But you don't need the dot also for multiplication, so you can just put 8 with the parentheses there. If you put the time sign there, it won't hurt anything. I'll show you in a second. But I'm going to start off doing it without it. So I have 8. I'm going to put parentheses right on top of the 8. And I'm going to do 19 plus 4 if you do it with me. Then you close the parentheses. I'm going to hit the shortcut square key. Then I'm going to go minus 9. I don't need the dot, but I am going to use the parentheses. 9 minus 8. Close your parentheses. And again, I'm going to use the shortcut square key. I have that, and you always look over it and reread it and make sure you have it in properly. Once I feel that I've had it in properly, you can always back up to check out the numbers that you put in. And after you do that, you get enter, and you're going to get the proper answer, which is 4223. Okay. Now, the other thing is I could have put in the multiplication sign. It wouldn't have hurt anything. It wouldn't have changed my answer. So let me go up here and just copy this, and I'm going to show you real quick. You don't have to know how to do this part. But you see I had 8, and then I'm going to put in a times, right? Just say if you type that. And then it was 9, if you look right here. It was 9 with the time sign. Alright? That. So you see, I just input it with the multiplication dots here. Anyway. So it's the same problem. I hit enter, and of course I get the same answer. So it doesn't matter whether or not you use the time sign, but you must use the parentheses all the time. All right, and the last one. What about fractions when we have them here? We have all numeric fractions. We can't put those letters into our calculator, at least not the way that you may eventually think. But what about this? All right, there are two ways to do it. The first way is to just do the top by itself. So I can do the top all by itself and write down, physically write down my answer. So I can say 10 plus 3 squared and write that down, right, which is 19 over. Then I can say 10 squared minus 9 squared. See, separately, and then write that, which is 19. What I have to remember is anytime I do it this way, I have to make sure I go back to this answer and check it in my calculator to make sure it is in its simplest form. So then I would go back and say 19 divided by 19, which is right here, and that's equal to, of course, 1. So your answer is 1. So anytime you do it in steps with the top first, then the bottom, you have to go back and check and make sure that this is in its simplest form, that it's reduced. Now, another way to put this in is to make the calculator realize that you have a top and a bottom. So, for example, what you can do is to make it realize that this stuff is at the top is put a parentheses around it. And then you can put a parenthesis around the bottom. This will indicate to the calculator that the first part is the top and the second part is the bottom. So I'm going to proceed and do that. I have the parenthesis. I have the 10 plus 3 squared. Close my parenthesis. I'm going to divide it. That's division divided by, and it's going to give you the slash. Again, in parentheses, 10 squared minus 9 squared. Alright? Once I do that and close the parentheses, I have everything in properly. As you can see, I'm going to get enter, hit enter, and it's going to give me 1. So if I do it this way, carefully watching what I put in, I don't have to then turn around and put in another step. Once I do the parentheses, the calculator is going to calculate the whole thing for me. So you can do this problem either way in your calculator. And that's how you put in the math problems into your calculator without doing any order of operations work for the whole numbers.